Hey, brothers and sisters, this is your favorite brother from another mother coming to you from the fabulous, luxurious country of the Philippines. Praise the living God, brothers and sisters. I hope you're doing all right. God is good all the time, and all the time God is good. You know, the Bible says when the enemy would come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord would raise up a standard against him. Hallelujah. We've got the victory, brothers and sisters, over all the power of the enemy. For Jesus said, he has authority over all these things in creation. Hallelujah. And he has given it unto us. Hallelujah. For he has given unto us a spirit of power, a spirit of love, and a sound mind. God has not given us a spirit of fear. God has not given us a spirit of fear, but he has given unto us a spirit of power, a spirit of love, and a sound mind. Hallelujah. Praise God. 2 Timothy 1:7. God has not given us a spirit of fear, but he has given unto us a spirit of power and of love and a sound mind. Hallelujah. Praise God, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. More love, more power, more of you in my life. More love. Sing it. Tell him, more power, more of you in my life. And I will worship you with all of my heart. And I will worship you with all of my strength. For you are my Lord. You are my Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. We bless you, Lord. Pray it to him if you don't want to sing it. Or you by yourself, you can sing. If you can't sing or can sing, it doesn't matter. It's by the Spirit, as the Spirit gives you the unction. Hallelujah. More love, more power, more of you in my life. Tell him, God has not given us the spirit of fear, but he's given unto us a spirit of love, power, and a sound mind. Hallelujah. More love, more power, more of you in my life. And I will worship you with all of my heart. I will worship you with all of my strength. For you are my Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are my Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Lord, that's what we need, Lord. More love, agape love, sacrificial giving love, your love. Hallelujah, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. More love, more power. Hallelujah, the power, Jesus said, you shall receive dunamis, dynamite power. You shall receive power from on high when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, that you might be a witness for me. Hallelujah, that you might operate in the gifts of the Spirit, that you might bear fruit of the Spirit. That's why you need the power of his Spirit. Hallelujah. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Not your power, but his power. It's not by might nor by power, but by his Spirit. It's his power. Dunamis, where we get the word dynamite. Power, hallelujah. More love, more power, more of you in my life, Lord Jesus Christ. More of the Lord Jesus Christ. It says, seek my face. Early will I seek him. And your face is all I seek. Hallelujah. You're supposed to seek his face, not his hands. If my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways and seek my face, not his hands. Lord, give me, give me, give me. Where's my present? Where's this? Where's that? I need this. I need that. People petition the Lord all the time. Hallelujah. But to seek his face. Hallelujah. More of you in my life. Not I need more cars in my life, more money in my life, but more of you in my life. Hallelujah. Apart from me, Jesus said, you can do nothing. More of you in my life, and I will worship you with all of my heart. I will worship you with all of my strength. Why? Because you are my Lord. Hallelujah. My Adonai. Adonai, Adonai, new. Hallelujah, Lord. We love you from our hearts. El Kadosh. Hallelujah, Lord. We bless you right now. Hallelujah, Lord God. Your face is all I see. And now. Hallelujah, Lord. We bless you. Hallelujah, we bless you, Lord. Yes, Lord, we bless you. We bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, Lord God. Thank you, Lord, for more love and more power. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for more love and more power. Hallelujah. Are you praying that? Pray that. Worship the Lord. Sing. For Jesus said the greatest commandments is to love the Lord God with all your heart, all your mind, all your strength, and all your soul, and love your neighbor as yourself. Hallelujah. That's what we're talking about here. Not lip service, not all those other things. Hallelujah. It's all about Him. It's all about you. Hallelujah. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, 'cause it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the things I've made it, but it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, 'cause it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. We love you. And Jesus, what a wonder you are. Yes, Lord. You are so gentle, so pure and so kind. Hallelujah. You shine, yes, Lord, like the bright morning star. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. We worship you and we praise you, Lord. Yes, Lord. I worship you, O mighty God. There is none like you. I worship you, O Prince of Peace. That is what I long to do, and I give you praise. For you are my righteousness. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. We bless you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Oh, bless the Lord. Oh, bless His holy name. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. More love, more power, more of you in my life, and I will worship you with all of my heart, and I will worship you with all of my strength, for you are my Lord. Hallelujah, yes, Lord. You are my Lord. Hallelujah, Lord, we bless you right now, Lord. Yes, we bow before you, Lord. Yes, to Him who sits on the throne and unto the Lamb. To Him who sits on the throne and unto the Lamb. Be blessing and honor and glory and power forever. Hallelujah, Lord. Yes, Lord. We bless you, Father. We bow before you. Yes, Lord. Unto you, yes, Lord. We bless you, Lord. We bow before your throne. All the angels, they're crying holy to the Lamb who was and is to come. Yes, Lord. Yes. All the angels, We're crying holy to the Lamb who sits upon the throne. Hallelujah. I hear angels singing praises. I see men from every nation bowing to you, oh my Lord. Hallelujah. And the symphony of praise arises.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Holy, holy, your God Almighty.
Yes, Lord.
Who was and is to come.
Yes, Lord.
All the angels, they're crying holy to the Lamb who sits upon the throne.
Hallelujah, Lord God. Yes, Lord. You are mighty to save.
You are mighty to save. Jesus conquered the grave.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus, he can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save. Jesus conquered the grave. Forever, author of salvation.
Yes.
Jesus conquered the grave.
Yes, Lord. We praise you, Lord Jesus. Forever offer author of salvation.
Hallelujah. Blessed be his name. Hallelujah. He is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Hallelujah. Praise be his holy name. Amen, brothers and sisters. I want to pray for you. I pray right now that you're in agreement with me to receive more love, more power, and more of Jesus in your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Open up your heart to the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, a lot of people ask me all the time. They say, people that's born again, they'll say something to me like this. They'll say, well, do I need to be baptized in the Holy Spirit in order to be raptured? Do I need to be baptized in the Holy Spirit in order to enter the kingdom of heaven? Do I need to operate in the gifts of the Spirit in order to enter the kingdom of heaven? No, you don't, brothers and sisters. John chapter 4, you have that wellspring of living water. You have that water in you that if you drink of it, the water that the Lord would give you, you will never thirst again. Hallelujah. It's Jesus said it's a life-giving water. Hallelujah. But in John chapter 7, we see that Jesus said, He who thirsts, let him come unto me, for out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. And it says, because the Holy Spirit had not been given yet, hallelujah, which was given on the day of Pentecost. Hallelujah. And as to the way people act, the people thought that the disciples were drunk. Hallelujah. And they mocked and laughed at them when they spoke in tongues when the Holy Spirit fell. And prophesied. It said they spoke in tongues and prophesied. And Peter said, these men are not drunk as you suppose. Seeing it's only the third hour of the day, 9 o'clock in the morning. They were drunk in the Spirit, but not as you suppose. It wasn't from wine. Hallelujah. But by the Spirit. Hallelujah. They were filled with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. The people will imagine they were drunk because of the way they were acting. So don't, whenever you hear some religious person telling you, you know, people saying they're drunk in the Spirit, people staggering around, or sometimes people fall down and all this and that, that's not from God. They thought the disciples were drunk on the day of Pentecost. That's why Peter, you know, they were mocking them. They were drunk on new wine, they said. Peter said, these people aren't drunk as you supposed. They were acting drunk, but not as you supposed, because it was with the new wine in the new wineskins. Hallelujah. The wine of joy, the Spirit of the living God. Hallelujah. Even John, in the book of Revelation chapter 1, when John saw, the Lord's having me talk on this, I don't know why. John, the Apostle John, who walked with Jesus, as a matter of fact, is the cousin of Jesus, who walked with Jesus for 3.5 years on this earth and wrote the Gospel of John. Revelation chapter 1, when he saw the Lord in his glorified body, as he really is, he says, I fell as if I was dead. He was slain in the Spirit. We see Elijah falling. We see Daniel falling under the power of the Holy Spirit and the presence of God. Hallelujah. Don't get involved with these religious people, brothers and sisters. Get your eyes off them and get your eyes on Jesus. You know, I've told this before. I'll tell it again. The Lord's leading me to tell it. I used to go to this Christian bookstore called the Master's Loft. It's only online now. I guess it's still online. They had a physical store and they had a coffee shop in there and all that. I used to go hang out in there when I was a new Christian and started going to school, and I used to, you know, read books for free. And then, you know, I bought a lot there too, and then drank coffee and all that, and meet other pastors there and talk and all this fellowship, pray, etc. The owners of the store were two Presbyterians, and we got to talking, and I told them that I was working as an altar worker at Assemblies of God. They were Presbyterian pastors who used to be pastors. Now they own this bookstore, and they said to me, "Well, you know, I visited Assemblies of God Church, and those people in there raising their hand. I don't know what they're doing. It's like they were pressuring me to raise my hands. I don't even know what that's all about." Well, the Word of God says, "I would have all men everywhere raising holy hands to heaven." Hallelujah. Praise God. That's where it comes from. And raising your hands to heaven is nothing. And I'll tell this again as the Lord is leading me. There was the story is a woman was going to quit her church because there were people in there gossiping. There were people in there jumping up and down. There was somebody ran around the church. Somebody spoke in tongues and all this. The woman was all upset. She told the pastor, "I want to leave the church." And the pastor said, "You can leave the church if you'll do one favor for me. You know, you can leave and I'll write you a letter or anything to help you find another church or whatever. If you'll do one thing for me. Get a glass of water and fill it all the way to the top, and I want you to walk around this church three times." The woman filled the glass of water to the top. She walked around the church three times. She said, "Okay, I'm ready to go." And then the pastor, during that time, some people came in and talked to the pastor. Somebody dropped something. There was things going on. The pastor said, "Did you hear that person who dropped a whole stack of books in the back of the church?" "No, I didn't hear it. I was trying to concentrate not to spill that water." And then he said, "Did you hear the person that came in and talked to me?" "No, I didn't know anybody else came in here. I was just oblivious to everything else was going on around me because I was concentrating on not spilling that full glass of water like you asked me to do and walk around the church three times." And of course, the pastor explained to the woman, "That's right, because if you keep your eyes on Jesus, you won't be caught up with what other people's doing." That's why on YouTube, there's some people that make YouTube videos, and they go watch other people's videos, and they think they said something about them, and they get upset and all this. There's a whole crew of people. They're worried about all that kind of stuff. And I only hear about it from people who message me about these kind of things. And that, you know, why I don't get involved? Because I got my eyes on that river of living water. I got my eyes on the throne of God. I got my eyes on Jesus, on the Lamb of God. I look unto Him. Hallelujah. "I will lift up mine eyes to the hills whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord who made heaven and earth." Hallelujah. Hallelujah. "He shall not suffer thy foot to be moved." Hallelujah. "The Lord who strengthens thee." Hallelujah. "The Lord who made heaven and earth. He shall not suffer thy foot to be moved. He will not. He will be your shade by day." Hallelujah. Hallelujah. "Praise God Almighty. I will lift up mine eyes to the hill whence cometh my help." I need more health. Help. And health too. I need more of Jesus into my life. I don't need more of people's opinions or ideas or anything else. I need more Jesus. That's why I tell people, you know, you get thrown off if somebody's making some wacky doctrine they heard on the internet. Oh, you have to be baptized in the Holy Spirit to be saved. In speaking tongues, they hear some wacky doctrine that there is no rapture, even though they may have believed in a rapture 20 years. They're all tore up about it. Get your eyes on Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And, you know, God has appointed people to be His pastors. Ephesians 4:11. He gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and some teachers for the perfecting of the saints. So there are people that the Lord has led to do that, but it's very few on YouTube that's really called by God. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. Get your eyes off these things. Get your eyes off the problems in your life. Get your eyes off your sickness. Get your eyes off all those things. You know, this is really a message from the Lord. God has not given us a spirit of fear. You know, I deal with people all the time. They have sickness and disease and cancer. It can be all kinds of stuff. And they're looking in fear at those things that's coming upon them. Brothers and sisters, get your eyes off cancer. Healing, just like, thank you, Lord, it's just like sin. The problem with these Judaizers, these sacred namer Judaizers who's trying to keep the law, besides the fact that it goes against the New Testament, it goes against the law of grace, which I've read from all the time, Romans chapter 3. We're not under the law, but we're under grace. Right in Romans chapter 3, it says it plainly in the whole book of Galatians. It's all over the New Testament. Acts chapter 15, we see that we're not under the law, we're under grace. People are sin conscious, not God conscious. It's not a matter of, oh, you know, and I have a brother who's an atheist. He was saying, oh, God's got a list of don'ts. It's not about a list of don'ts. It's about a list of do's. And there's really only one thing, and that's to run to Jesus. Run into the light of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And the things of this world will grow strangely dim in the light of His glorious grace. Hallelujah. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in His wondrous face. And the things of this world will grow strangely dim in the light of His glorious grace. Hallelujah. So when you come to Jesus, the sin falls off. I've given this analogy 100 times, and the Lord is leading me to do it again. I'll tell you what you do. You go into a sealed room that's totally dark, and then you have a flashlight, and you put it in a shoebox. You go into that room. You open up the lid of that shoebox. The light from that flashlight is going to put light in the whole room. The darkness flees away. You go into a room with 1,000 lights in it that's fully lit. Carry that shoebox full of darkness and carry that shoebox in and open up the shoebox. What happens? The light goes into the shoebox. Hallelujah. Get into the light. Stop trying to flee the darkness, but go to Jesus. What it's called positive sanctification. Run to the Master. Hallelujah. Call upon the name of the Lord. Jesus, save me, like Peter did when he started sinking in the water. Why did Peter start sinking into the water when he walked on water? A lot of people have never read their Bible. They don't know Peter also walked on water. The only disciple that had the guts and the faith to try to do it. He walked out on the water. It says he was walking on the water toward Jesus. As soon as he started looking at the storm all around him, boom, he started to sink. And then, of course, Peter had enough sense to say, Lord, save me. And Jesus said, oh, ye of little faith. Ye of little faith, why did you doubt? And Peter had great faith compared to all the other disciples, but Jesus said it was little faith. Hallelujah. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Hallelujah. Get your eyes off your flesh. Get your eyes off pornography. Get your eyes off of drinking. Get your eyes off of smoking. Get your eyes off of what, and the first topic I talked, get your eyes off what your neighbor's doing. You know, people are so obsessed. That's why a lot of people don't go to church. When you go to church, there's those cliques. There's people that are sitting there, oh, look at you, you know, so, especially women, you know, so-and-so, she came in here, her dress is so short, or whatever, all this nonsense. All, you know, that's what you deal with, and that's why people don't go to church. A lot of people who are Christians don't go to church because of all that stuff. But I say to you, if you find a church that's preaching the word, like by the grace of God, I preach the word the best I can, and there's a few of us online, and of course, I'm sure there's churches you can find where preaching the word, don't worry about what the people are doing. The place is filled with the Holy Spirit. Focus on that. Receive. You know, be fed by the word of God. And then, you know what? I want to say this as I said that. When we do praise and worship, it's not for you to be fed. When you do praise and worship, it is worshiping God. It's edifying the Lord, speaking to the Lord, praising the Lord, or worshiping the Lord. Hallelujah. We should praise the Lord or worship the Lord. A lot of hymnals are not praising or worshiping the Lord. Even though I like them and I sing them as the Lord leads me, that's really like Sunday school to music. Teaching theology to music, you know, most of your old hymnals are all about you, and about me, and about the church, not about Jesus. Very few. As a matter of fact, I used to preach on that sometimes whenever I preach in a Baptist church. I'll preach on that, a whole sermon on it. But one is like, how great thou art. Hallelujah. That is a praise song. Hallelujah. How great thou art. How great thou art. Hallelujah. When Christ shall come, with shouts of acclamation, the rapture, to take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Hallelujah. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Hallelujah. Then sings my soul. I have a key. Never mind. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Hallelujah. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Hallelujah. Praise God. God is good, brothers and sisters. He's good all the time. Get your eyes on Jesus. Hallelujah. Keep your eyes on the prize. Ours is not to wonder why, but to do or die. Hallelujah. To do God's will. To be conformed to the image of Christ. Hallelujah. To be a child of God and a servant of God and a soldier of God. Hallelujah. And be a medic in the hospital of the Lord. The church is a hospital and an army. Hallelujah. Praise God. Be a soldier and a nurse. Hallelujah. To the sick. Be a physician's assistant to the great physician, right? I know someone had mentioned that in a comment. Well, of course, that's used to be part of my testimony. I used to tell that all the time. I wanted to be a physician's assistant, but the Lord stopped me and led me to be an assistant to the great physician. So praise God for that, brothers and sisters. It's a much more better, rewarding, and of course, eternally rewarding option also, brothers and sisters. God is good. I ask you guys to hear a word for somebody. Stand fast, hold fast, and see the glory of God. Stand still and see the glory of God. Hallelujah. Hold fast. Help is on the way. Hallelujah. Hold fast. Help is on the way. There's a song. I think that's by Third Day, maybe. Hold fast. Help is on the way. Hallelujah. Hold fast. That song is for somebody. That word is for somebody. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. God bless you all, and I will be talking to you soon. And again, I'm making my schedule for the U.S. And all those people that, like I said, I've been watching it for years. When I make a video about the rapture dreams that the Lord gave me and stuff, which I need to make an ADD version of the last rapture dream I had. But I didn't. But when I do, I have all those followers who watch those videos. And then when I make a regular video, I know those who comment and watch those videos too. Those are the people, if I had my choice, that's the people I want to meet the fellowship with. The other ones I like to meet with and pray for them, because they need the Holy Spirit to do a work in their mind, give them the power and the strength and the love to get out of the kiddie pool, out of the shallow end of the pool, and get over into the deep end, because it's by the Spirit. So pray that tonight, all of you, that's from the Lord. More love, more power, and more of you in my life. Hallelujah. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but He has given unto us a spirit of power, a spirit of love, and a sound mind. God has not given us a spirit of fear. God has not given us a spirit of fear, but He has given unto us a spirit of power, a spirit of love, and a sound mind. 2 Timothy 1:7. Get it down into your spirit. Hallelujah. God bless you all, brothers and sisters. And I just thank the Lord, because I'll be in the States in about a month. Praise God Almighty. I'm ready to be in the U.S. for a season, brothers and sisters. I've had, after 12 years in the Philippines and working on my 12th year. And, of course, I spent 6 months out of the last 3 years in the States. But before that, I really didn't come to the States. I think I came twice for 30 days in the first 9 years I was over here. And praise God, praise God, praise God, brothers and sisters. I tell you what, and it's, I can just say praise God. You know, the average missionary makes it 1 year in the mission field. And there's not, do you hear about those people that stay their whole life? Well, there's not that many that do that. But of course, it's up to the Lord. But the Lord wants me to go to Germany, for, as I've told in videos, for 3 years. But I don't know when that'll be. So I ask you to pray for that, brothers and sisters who are praying for Joshua's ministry. For the ministry here is Joshua's ministry, and then for the mission work the Lord would have me do in Europe, and I believe based out of Germany, or maybe on the Poland area, border area, or Czech Republic, and be based out there all over Europe. When I said Germany, of course, that's true all over Germany, all over Europe. The Lord would make a way of me connect with a network of, like, there's American missionaries all over Europe, and Lord would make a way for me to get connected with them. I already have one connection that will go through. But anyway, brothers and sisters, in the dream that I had, the Lord showed me people coming out, young people coming out of the Lutheran church, and I was ministering to them outside the church, outside the Lutheran church, like crusades and stuff. So that'd be awesome. But it could be symbolic for, just in these American missionary meetings all over Europe. And by the grace of God, I'm going to go around every weekend and go to a different place all over Europe, whatever. During those times, and they need it, because they've got this Muslim invasion going on. Europe is only 2% Christian, and God is obviously not finished with them. I believe, and I don't even want to hear no discussion on this video about it. The revived Roman Empire will be the empire that the Antichrist will rule over, and I think that's clearly taught in several scriptures. I've done lots of videos on it, that the Antichrist will come out of the revived Roman Empire, as in Daniel 9:26 and 9:27 and other verses. Connect to that. Like I said, I made videos about it. And this is standardly held theology among evangelical theologians. This is the standard. The Roman Revived Roman Empire will produce the Antichrist. And there's other things you've heard are alternative theories by just a few people. But anyhow, Lord knows. So, but anyway, there's, you know, God has a harvest there in Europe. God's not finished with them. God is not finished with them until the rapture happens. Or even then, during the tribulation, the Lord's going to be saving people. There'll be the tribulation saints. So, but God's not finished with any place in the world. And Europe hasn't, I don't know if they've ever had a revival. I don't know. England has had revivals, but maybe, and Scotland and has had revivals, and Wales and all that. But I don't know that Europe's ever had a revival. Anyway, there were some groups that were, you know, in the Dark Ages, there were groups that were in revival, the Waldensians, I think, and some groups like that. But anyway, God bless you all, brothers and sisters. I'll see you soon. As for your prayers, everything is, I'll be going to the States. Where we'll be staying in the States, I'm not sure yet, which we deal with that every year. I just go as the Lord leads. It's up to the Lord. I'm always open to even do a temporary pastor of a church that needs a new pastor. I've never done that, but you know, there's churches like the pastor leaves, or sometimes a pastor dies, and they say, hey, we want an interim pastor until we can hire a new one. You know, maybe the Lord will make a way for me to do that for 90 days or something, and who knows? I'm just open to anything the Lord wants to do, and I plan on doing a schedule to visit you guys, so just let me know. And I love you guys so much. Those who pray for this ministry and those who communicate with me, those who have helped with the orphanages and the feeding programs and all that, through prayer or financially, etc., I appreciate all of it. I love all you guys. I can't do it without you. You know, God is using you as an instrument like he's using me as an instrument, so praise God. And the pastors that here in the Philippines and all that. God is blessing us and making a way, so praise God for that. God bless you all. Love you all.